And on the count of 3, 2, 1, here you go, guys. First question on your screen. Where would you find a Paul and ratchet mechanism? Very common. Let's see if you know what a Paul and ratchet mechanism is. So all the questions will have only 20 seconds. So mark your answers quickly. 3, 2, 1. Right. What is the answer? Bicycle. So the Paul and ratchet mechanism is in bicycle. You know the when you yes, silence. Mute yourself. So when you reverse the pedal, right? There is a sound which comes, continuous sound which comes when you reverse it. So hence the cycle doesn't go in the reverse direction, only in the forward direction it goes. This is because of Paul and ratchet mechanism, right? Very, very important. In so it basically, if you do some Google search, you'll get it. Okay, so bicycles in the rear wheel, Paul and ratchet mechanism is there, which helps the bicycle to move only in one direction. If you reverse by mistake, someone takes a reverse of start pedaling in the reverse direction, it will not let him or her do it. Okay, so the first leaderboard is here. Here is the first leaderboard. Very quick. Oh wow, Tarun in PS Yashwant. Good, very good. So first leaderboard. Let's see if it is maintained. Next question on your board. Okay, so the question is, what is this? Easy. So most of you would have seen this while your light bulb. No, it's a spark plug. So most of you have got it right. So spark plug, you will study this in 10th grade electrostatics. So yes, in automobiles and various other equipments it is used. Okay,
so I have a fact about it.
Yes, please go ahead.
So, like, if you see at the spark plug, right at, like, if you have that picture again, like, there's this, right at the bottom, there's, like, in between the spark area, you have extremely valuable metals like palladium and gold and silver and stuff like that. Not gold, but you can have, like, silver, platinum and all those metals.
So after the next question, I will illustrate the functioning of what exactly it does and how it's related to your academics as well, okay? So here is the next question, and before that, the leaderboard. So there is some Abhishek this time got it correct. Very good. So here is the next question. So they are used in So you see this gap here, right, between the two metal pieces. This gap actually helps in producing a huge amount of spark. Just in I knew it, and hence you got trapped, right? So it is not used in diesel engines or steam engines. It is used only in petrol engines, right? No, it's not in diesel engines. Spark plugs are only found in petrol engines. Okay, now concept clear. So in petrol engine you have compression. I don't know if you have gone through the functioning of an engine. So what happens in engine is the fuel and air mixture is compressed, the temperature rises up, and there's a spark which generates the flue gases. But in diesel engines, the compression is double that of a petrol engine. So hence the temperature is good enough to create a spark. You don't require to ignite the fuel. You don't require a spark. So only petrol engines, always remember. So if you have a diesel vehicle at home, Okay, so hence there was a trap and steam engines. Come on, yeah. In steam engines, you have to feed a lot of coal, and you know the spark is not needed because there the thing which pushes the piston is steam. You can't really burn the steam. Okay, next. Read about. So most of you have got it wrong. Okay, so Aditya Supreme Best is now on first position. Okay, chalo. Next question, guys. What is this? Very commonly, common sight, very common sight. Correct? You see it daily, almost near your household. Keeps blasting. Okay, does it? Yeah, this is one thing which really, you know, good. So most of you know it. That is an electrical transformer. What does a transformer do? It steps up or steps down the voltage. Okay, now the picture which you saw was a step up or step down. No, not DC, only AC. So it was a step down or step up. It was a step down transformer, right? So it reduces the voltage because at your house, in your household, you require only
So
two.
how can you figure whether it's step up or step down?
Now in your locality, near this is the equipment which you see near your household, right? You have seen this. Now what happens is the power at very high voltage comes from the, you know, the generating station. So gradually it is decreased to 220 volt. It is, you know, when it starts from the generation point, generation station side, it is as high as 200 kilovolt. Okay, so very, very high voltage. And now in your household, you use only 240 volts around that. Okay, chalo. Next is this. Now, leaderboard first. So this was a very common, easy. Oh, see, you can see everyone has got it correct. Okay, very good. Only one shuffle. Next. This will be a fact. You must know this. So now you can see what is the, you know, K means kilo, thousand. So I think you know this, right? So let's see. Awareness, see, most of you are not aware. I have said input side voltage. So input side, unmute yourself, please. Input side voltage is 11 kV. So 11 kV is reduced to 440 volt. And then from 440 to 2 volt, 240 is your phase to neutral voltage. You'll come to know about all of this when you study electricity, but you must know that the lines, if you by mistake anyone touches, the other day there is a transformer near my home and one cat got stuck in the input side. Okay, and we had to call the Bescom people, switch it off and rescue the cat. Okay, if by mistake you'd have touched that live wire 11 kV, and then you would have witnessed direct evaporation from solid to gas, no liquid. Okay, so next question. Oh, this is a leaderboard. Good. So not everyone was aware of this. Now you are aware. Please remember. Next. Output is 440 volt, line to line voltage. 440. You all use this, but do you know which technology is used to manufacture these? This is the same technology with which the fuel tanks are made of bikes. Okay, it's called blow molding. Very good. Most of you have known. Know this. So blow molding is used to even you must know. For example, all these fuel tanks. Have you seen the bikes on the bike just next to the the rider, there's a fuel tank. That fuel tank is also made using this technology. Okay, so you have something and you blow air inside it and it becomes that shape. Okay, so next. So, very good, Aditya Supreme, best NPS YPR. Next. You must know this. How high you are right now from mean sea level? Easy. Where do you see this information? Where is it written? Where is it written? Where is mean sea level usually written? Easy? Yeah, it's 915, 915.20 again, no problem, right? So it is 915 meters. Where do you see this written? So when, you know, any airplanes, no, any railway station you'll see. Whenever you enter any railway platform, in the railway station, wherever the station name is mentioned, they will also mention the mean sea level height. Okay, so Majestic, if you go sometime, you will see that written over there. Okay, general awareness. Yes, you must be observant, guys. This is the learning. Next question before that, leaderboard. Okay, so not everyone knew this. Okay, so don't chat in lag, this thing. Don't chat only, you know. So hence, just focus on the next question. Here is the next question. You must have seen GSM. Where is GSM written? Okay, so see, not everyone knows. What is GSM, by the way? It is a measurement of. What is GSM? Anyone knows what is GSM?
Quality of paper.
Yeah, grams per square meter. Right?
Yes, sir.
So
the
it's like,
quality of paper. Like,
yes,
all
very good.
Use, like, really
yes, yes. So grams per square meter is required. Why? For printing, every printer has a particular GSM requirement. Okay, so hence, you know, if you feed higher GSM paper into a.
So I think normal printing paper is GSM 40.
70. So A4 sheet which you go for Xerox, it's 70. Right? The papers which you use, it's around 100 GSM at max normally, and you can go.
Watercolor papers are 240.
Yes. So depends on, you know, GSM is also used in plastic sheets. So wherever there is a laminate, it is measured in GSM, grams per square meter. Any laminate structure is there, you'll get GSM there. Okay. Next. Leaderboard. Not everybody knew it. GSM is also a mobile technology, right? Communication technology, if you are aware of that. Next. In terms of purity, 22 karat gold is equivalent to. So next time you visit any jewelry shop, you will see they will give you a certificate of purity. There one number is mentioned. Right, Raghav Pandey, good. So 91.6, the number 916 is written in most of the gold jewelry. If you are right now wearing it, you can check any of your, you know, lockets or bracelets or whatever, it will be written 916. Right, earrings, yes, so it will be mentioned, check. Someone would be wearing at home, or if you have any. Okay, sure. Next, awareness. So lots of shuffling is happening. That means not everyone knows all the questions. That's good. Okay, next question on your screen, guys. petrichor. I hope you have heard of this word, petrichor. Very, very intoxicating. What is petrichor? The first smell of the rain. Okay, so the moment I said intoxicating, everyone marked nicotine. Right, so geosmin is produced is produced by a bacteria. So whenever water falls on, you know, very slow moving rain, so it will always be when light rain is there. When heavy rains are there, you will not get this smell. So light rain falls on ground, the bacteria which is there produces geosmin, and you know, this is right. So geosmin is the compound for that smell, and it's really, really great smell. Okay, next. Petrichor. Petri means stone and core is fluid or blood flowing in Greek gods. Okay, so Monisha is on first position. Very good. Chalo, fastest was Himanshu. Next question. You must know this. If you are aware, you must be knowing this. There is
so it will be written on the back in red color.
Yes. And which law says all this? So there is a rule in India. It's called Drugs and Cosmetic Rules, 1945. Okay. Which has all these categorizations. So Schedule H drugs are without prescription. In fact, without prescription, you should not take any medicine. But Schedule H drugs are little, you know, what do you say? If not taken with a proper prescription, it can be hazardous. So Schedule H. Right? What did I say? The rules are written. Where is it written? Where is the Schedule H? Schedule H is mentioned in something called Drugs and Cosmetic Rules 1945. Okay? Remember that. There are lots of other schedules as well. For example, there is Schedule C, Schedule D and all that. So it talks about, in fact, there is discussion on different types of poisons also. Okay? So everything is mentioned over there. So this is where it comes from. Okay? Guys, you should be very careful while chatting anything or writing anything in the comment chat box. Okay? Chalo. Good. Next question. PM 2.5 and PM 10 are food colors, narcotics, refrigerants, pollutants. Okay, what is PM? Prime Minister 2.5. Okay, most of you know it. What is PM, by the way? PM means?
Particulate
matter. What is 2.5 and 10 then? What is 2.5 and 10 here?
So the diameter.
And diameter of what? I mean, what is 2.5? What? Kilometers? Light years? Microns, right? So whenever you are saying any physical quantity, it has to have a unit attached to it. So 2.5 and 10 microns are the diameter of the sphere in which that particle can accommodate. Okay, minimum diameter of the sphere in which the particle can accommodate. So, you know, very, very dangerous. PM 2.5, very, very dangerous because it's not filtered while you breathe in. So, very difficult. Okay. Shallow. So these are harmful pollutants. Very good. So all the top 10 people knew it except Raghav, I believe everyone knew it. Okay. Shallow. Next question. How many wards your city is divided into? Political question. But you must be aware, because after some time you are going to vote for these wards, isn't it? What is a ward, by the way? It's not hospital ward. The entire municipal administrative area is divided into some areas. Yes, how many? So many people didn't know this. There are 198 wards in Bangalore. Okay, so each ward is represented by whom? What is the name of that post? Each ward is corporator. Very good. And where do they sit? Where do they go? Where is their office?
The municipal corporation.
Yes, very good. And what do they do? So what are they responsible for? So your local roads, your electricity, your drainage is not a headache of your central government or state government. It is the responsibility of local municipality, right? People don't know. And actually they blame the central government and the state government for their local roads, drainage, and garbage collection and all that. These are the responsibilities of local corporator or the municipal corporation, right? Okay, sure. Yes, so now shufflings are happening multiple number of times. That's real fun. Let's see if you are really aware of these premier institutes of India. Which one is not in Bangalore? Bangalore has a very good academic environment in terms of research and development in science and engineering. Which one is not there in Bangalore? National Chemical Laboratory is not in Bangalore, it is in Pune. Okay, so most of you have got it correct. Good. So NPRI is there in Bangalore. Raman Research Institute is very much in Bangalore. Indian Institute of Astrophysics is also in Bangalore. But National Chemical Laboratory, these are CSIR labs, guys. So National Chemical Laboratory is Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. CSIR, it takes care of industrial research and development in India. Multiple labs are there. NPRI also falls in their administration. Okay. Okay, so Mosi, you are not aware of your city. That's not cool. You must be aware of your city. Okay, so next is this. Which of the district borders Bangalore? And in which direction it is? Easy. You must know in and around, in and out about your city. See, lots of people are like, oh, what is the awareness of my dear National Public School children? What is happening? You are not. So you are aware of Fortnite and PUBGs and Model United Nations, but unfortunately you don't know about your neighborhood. It's Ramnagara. Between Tumkuru and Bangalore, there is another district called Bangalore Rural. Okay, so hence, right? So please be aware of your city leaderboard. Okay. So good. Ramnagar is the place where have you heard of the movie Sholay? While going to Mysore, it is there, isn't it? So Sholay was shot in that place. Next question on your screen. Google it quick. Google, my intention is, even if you Google, I don't mind. Learn but remember. Google in 3 seconds, good. Learn and remember. These are not just to win any quiz. You must learn also. It's easy, three, yeah, see, everybody has. What are the districts? Can you tell me? Name. Name, name. Mangalore. No, Mangalore is not district, my dear. Mangalore falls in Dakshin Kannada district. Dakshin Kannada, Udupi, Uttar Kannada. Three. Manipal is also not district. Uttar Kannada, Dakshin Kannada, and Udupi. Uttar Kannada, after that Goa comes, right? So remember, Goa, Uttar Kannada, Udupi, then Dakshin Kannada, in which Mangalore, famous fort of Mangalore is. Very famous fort. Okay. I am Kannadiga now. Come on, yaar. Wherever you stay, you are of that place. Chalo, very good. Maintain the lead. Next. Which of the following is non-edible oil? Let me see who guesses. Who guesses this or who knows it already? Very common, that is a very commonsensical question. Easy. Let me see how many of you are aware. Really? Oh, chalo, good. Okay, this is what the trap was. Yep. So all cottonseed is also edible. Right? So all three of them. Google if you can. Google, Google, Google. Chalo. Right? So now palm oil, rice bran oil, cotton oil, cotton seed oil, all are edible. That's what Tanvi. Awareness. See the awareness level. Now you can figure out. The very shuffling of the leaderboard can tell you how aware people are. Okay, next awareness question. Good. Oh, I think it is visible to you. Have you seen this somewhere? CE written. If you see your mobile phone, it will be written over there. Not on the mobile phone as such, on the package. Let me see. Okay, okay. So this was, most of you have seen this. This is related to European Union actually. So they have come up with these standards on environment, health and safety hazards, safety standards, right, in Europe, in European market. Mostly it is actually for European market. So if they are not CE certified, you cannot sell those product in those markets. Okay. Now it is also used across the globe. So many people take that as a standard. Okay. So you have seen this many a times in electronic gadgets and other things. Chalo, next. Yeah, what happened, Raghav? Oh my God, what is this? Oh, oh my God. Okay, next. Come on, come on, come on. Use your phone. This one is. Why is a safety match called a safety match? Have you ever explored? Why is a safety match called safety match? Safety. Safety pin. Why is it called safety pin? Let me see. Oh, cool. Most of you know it. That's cool. So safety matches is that until and unless, you know, as you can figure out from the, you know, so safety match. So until and unless, you know, so deliberately this red phosphorus is put on the box so that until and unless you match the stick with the box, it will not light up automatically. So that's why it is called safety match. Okay. So you need to strike it against that. Right. So hence, good. Let me see. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Yeah, then it will be, but safety match, normally the temperature, you are increasing the temperature. No, Ashish, if you put that in a flame, it will automatically burn, but it will not automatically burn in normal temperatures. Okay. Correct. Ashish, understood. Chalo. Tarun is leading. Have you done this experiment at home? Today you try this. Put on the gas burner and sprinkle some sodium chloride over it. Tell me the color you will get. Which color is it? Yellow, yes. So in chemistry, later on you will study. No, yellow. So later on you will see that sodium emits yellow light when burnt. Sodium, yeah. I don't know if you have done this experiment. Have you ever explored this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so hence you just do it today, Monisha. Don't believe Google. Do it and experiment yourself. So you put it on a flame, sodium chloride will emit yellow color. Okay, I have done this since I am saying. Okay, never mind. Chalo, next. See, I have performed all of these experiments. So if you check my Instagram and Facebook page, you'll get the video of that as well. Okay, chalo. That's nice. Next. Let me see how many of you are ready. Avid. What is HURB? HURB is books, right? So you don't all of you read books. So it's what is ISBN stand for?
International Standard for Book Number.
Okay, so Google says that. Great, very good. Who issues ISBN? Where, which authority do you go to if you write a book? Explore that today. Okay, here is the which authority gives you. No, God cannot be approached by mortal humans. So far we have not been able to crack that. So sorry, Monisha. Next. Yeah, Akshay approached God today. Okay. So, how many digits are there in ISBN? This should be easy. Google it. Earlier there used to be 9. So have you ever, you know, paid attention to these details, guys? Just tell me honestly, anyone who knew it or anyone ever paid attention to figure it out? Anyone? Just trust, you know, frankly, tell me very honestly so that I could sense that whether, you know. Okay. Oh, you knew. Sriram knew. Okay. Not me. I don't read books. Okay. Very good. So there is a 13 digit barcode is there. Yes. It will always be on the back side of the book. Very good. Chalo. Next. Guys, enjoying or not? Easy question. All of you enjoying or not? Did you like the quiz? Good. Very good. Okay, so hence, oh, so cool. People are aware about blood pressure. Okay, what is blood pressure? Anyone? What is blood pressure? Can anyone tell me? Pressure on what?
So it is the pressure of the blood applied to reverse the effect of the atmospheric pressure on the body.
No, dear. This is a wrong information. What is blood pressure? Pratik says arteries. What is that arteries? See, blood vessels are
the pumping of the blood through the arteries.
So basically, it's the speed at which the blood goes through the arteries.
So see, what happens is whenever a fluid flows.
So it's systolic and diastolic.
Oh, these are all technical jargons. What is pressure? Pressure is force applied per unit area. Correct? Now, if there is blood, there is pressure in blood. That means blood is, sorry,
the
okay. Yes, someone is saying. Come on, go ahead.
So it's basically like the amount of pressure put like on.
Yes, pressure put by whom on what is the question?
By the blood on the walls.
Very good. So pressure put by the blood on the walls of the blood vessel is called blood pressure. Now blood vessels are not exposed to atmosphere on the other side. So hence, you know, I know where your explanation, what Monisha explained, was coming from, but that's not the thing. Right? What does Google say to that? Mute. First mute. So that's the blood pressure. Blood pressure is pressure applied by blood. So always remember, it's not only blood which applies pressure. Whenever in your, let's say, washroom or in your plumbing circuits, when water flows, it applies some pressure on the walls of the duct. Every time a fluid flows across any duct, it will apply pressure on the walls. That's the fluid pressure. In this case, it is blood pressure. Right? So, very good. Now, sphygmomanometer. So, manometer is usually used for measuring pressure. Okay, so Tarun is still leading. Very good. Nice. Let's go to the next question. Let me now see. You knew this, Pranav? Very good. Easy. Let me see the awareness level. Oh, cool. Most of you know it. Right. 120 by 80 millimeter Hg. What is the atmospheric pressure, by the way, guys? ATM is the unit of one atmosphere is called 1 ATM. So, what is atmospheric pressure in mmHg?
760
mmHg. So that means the pressure of the blood is lesser than atmospheric pressure. And why are there two numbers, 120 and 80? Which one is the blood pressure? Or both are the blood pressure? What is that 120 by 8? Max and min, is it? So someone was mentioning systolic and diastolic. So that's this. So once the heart, you know, if you know ventricle squeezes the blood out, that's the highest pressure. When it opens up, it creates some kind of a vacuum and then blood flows in. Diastolic, systolic. Right? So, understood. Now, but tell me this thing, 120 by 80, that means you are saying the blood pressure is lesser than atmospheric pressure. Is that so? Yes or no? If 760 mm is the atmospheric pressure, then why is 120 by 80 mmHg? What is the significance of 120 by 80 then? Why are we saying 120 mmHg when 760 mmHg is atmospheric pressure? Why is 120 mm the highest pressure? Now this is called gauge pressure, guys. Please understand, in physics, gauge pressure means this is over and above atmospheric pressure. So your blood pressure in absolute terms will be 760 plus 120. That is 880 mmHg of pressure is there in absolute terms. Got it? So it is over and above atmospheric pressure. Got the point? Right? So this is called gauge pressure. Right? So it's over and above the atmospheric pressure. Oh, most of you knew it already. Yeah, that's nice. Good. Very good. Next question. Tanya is already bored. You must have seen this multiple number of times. Today also I had posted one. Very commonly used these days. Answer is Japan. Oh, cool. So people have cool. Very good. So the name of the person was Masahiro Hara, right? 1994 was the year. and the company was then so aware where he was putting these codes to identify components of vehicles and other components in the shop floor. Masahiro Hara, right? What code? That code was for some Wi-Fi. Okay, I just picked it from Wikipedia. Okay, cool. Very good. Next. Let me see how many of you know this. Problem is you, okay, you can Google also, don't worry. No problem. So have you ever thought of these things? What does SIM stand for? How many of you actually knew it? Forget about it. You can Google, that's okay. But how many of you actually knew it? I knew it. Right? Now you know, right? How does the mobile towers identify you with a number? So subscriber identity module or identification module, anything. Right? So keep knowing. Knowing is the final objective of this kind of session. Keep learning. Okay, so very good. So we'll now move a little faster. Anika is on the first place now. Sure. Amount of rainfall is measured in, let's say, how many of you read newspaper and are aware about it? Amount of rainfall. Easy?
The liter spelling is wrong.
Oi, Raghav. Vihan Singh, you're on mute. Raghav was also on mute. Right? Yes. See, people are not that aware. It's measured in centimeters. Okay, so area doesn't matter because whether it is 2 centimeters square or 20 centimeters square, the height attained by water will be same. Isn't it? So hence, centimeters. So neither square centimeters, not milliliters, not millimeter cube.
8, 1, 5, 6.
Right? You can also measure in inches. That's also done. Right? How much India, how much rainfall does India get? Any idea around how much? Monsoon gives 0. 10,000. No. 200 centimeter approximately. Around that. No. It varies place to place. On an average, you can say around 200. Okay, next. So, only Gandhar and Ahan. Fish go blub blub, knew it. Okay. So, very good. Next question. This thing was in news recently. Why was it in news? There was a company called SpaceX. And it was the first non-government space agency which sent humans to ISS. First agency to do that. Headed by a guy called Elon Musk.
So, and not just that, it was the first time in 9 years US astronauts got to lift out of US by a US rocket. Because they didn't have a rocket, they used to use the Soyuz rocket made by the Russians.
You know, so one Indian actually perished. What was her name? I was preparing for my JEE then. The day was 2nd February 2002. Kalpana Chawla.
Kalpana Chawla.
Very good. So, you must know all this. Great. Nice. Nice. So let's go to 400 kilometers is the orbit. It looks majestic. I don't know if you have seen what is her, Sunny Williams, right? What is her name? Sunita Williams. Yes. There's a very famous video of ISS. Sunita Williams video of life in ISS. Go check it out on YouTube. Okay. Very good. Let's go to the next one. Life in ISS. Let me see how many of you really are aware about it. Easy. very easy. Right? Legit decay. Okay, heat food, yes, microwave oven. So magnetron is responsible for generating those microwaves. Okay, so when a fluctuating microwave actually does what? Any polar molecule inside the food will start oscillating because of the microwave. And when oscillation starts, it starts, you know, the food resists the oscillation, heat is developed, and a very uniformly heated food material is obtained. So microwave oven is the magnetron is present in the microwave oven. Yes, oscillating waves, correct. So when a microwave hit those food particles, the polar molecules start oscillating, and that creates heat. Okay, cool. Next. Now this is again you will study in grade 10, but you must know this, very very common. Heating effects of current. Oh, I gave the hint only. Cool, induction cooktop, right? So, you know, the metal surface, there are lots of current produced in the metal surface because of this induction. The concept is called electromagnetic induction. So there's a coil. If you get a, you know, old induction cooktop, open it up and see there's a coil. That coil creates magnetic, you know, electromagnetic induction in the vessel, which is there kept on top. Current starts flowing. It is resisted by the metal. Heat is produced and the food gets heated. That's the funda. Next. Okay, Mike. Right? So lots of variations are happening. That's nice. Next. Keep. Yes. Yes, Monisha.
The only reason I skipped from the leaderboard was because my network went.
I'm sorry. Sorry. You can just reload. No problem. You'll be where you were. Have you tried this?
My network is not working itself.
Okay.
So I have to skip a few questions.
Oh, I see. Sorry. So this is your device's IMEI number. IMEI holds for? What is IMEI? IMEI means Mobile Equipment Identity. Right? Okay. Chalo. Leaderboard. So you try it and save it. So it is used for anti-theft purposes. If you know your IMEI number, if your phone gets stolen, you can block the phone itself. So it will become invalid. The person who has stolen the phone cannot use it for making calls or any use. But he can still click pictures, I believe. Yeah. And he can use the Wi-Fi and all that. But he can't make calls. Yeah. This must be known to all of you. If you are natives of Bangalore, most of you would have been born here in Bangalore only. So you must know who founded it. Right? There is a famous, you know, airport name. Yes. Okay. So most of you are knowing this. So I don't need to throw more light on this. It was in 16th century, by the way, where he did. Okay. Next. Who's those three? That I will not tell you now. Now let me see this much. This one. The 50 in the registration plate denotes. All of you would have seen this plate, this kind of plate in your. Easy. Let's see. Many people do not know this, right? It's regional transport office. So every city is divided into Yes, 02 or 03 is, I think, that place near KR Puram. So everyone, so K0105 is Jayanagar. See, yes, good. So that's how it is. Mute. So 03 is Indranagar. Yes, earlier it was Indranagar. Now it has moved to Puram. That is, what is that? KR?
1565.
Okay. Mute yourself, or I'll have to mute you. Next. How many assembly constituencies are there in Bangalore city? That means how many MLAs do you elect? You don't elect, we elect. You will be electing after 4 years. So by the time next, I think next election will happen. No, not even next election. Next to next election, you will be able to. In Bangalore city, you must know this, and you must also know who is your, in which constituency you lie, you are located. See, people are not aware. People are not aware at all. People are not aware, right? There are 28 constituencies in your city. You must know the name of your, right, constituency as well. You must know your MLA's name. You must know your constituency's name. You must know your ward number. All these are general awareness facts. Next. Again, this is also important. So Lok Sabha is for member of parliament. How many member of parliament does Bangalore send every general election, every 5 years? So right now, how many MPs are there in Bangalore who are representatives of Bangaloreans? Oh, let me see. This also, oh, see, people are not really aware. Okay, so three, Bangalore North, Bangalore Central, Bangalore South. Three constituencies are there. For every constituency, one MP is elected. Okay. That is not in city, Anika. Bangalore ruler is outside city limits. Okay, next. This so everybody knows. This you must be aware. These days required very much. You must be trained at it as well. Last year we gave training on CPR. Anything versus CPR? I think we went to NPS and HSR and Koramangala also. Yes, where we, using virtual reality, we gave this training. You know, on what? On Microsoft HoloLens. It was amazing experience. Okay, so many people know this. Cardiac arrest, right? So, very good. So it's an emergency, not, it's not a permanent and a very, you know, effective all the time solution. It's for emergency, just to, you know, supply air so that the death of tissue can be delayed for some time. That's it. I don't know if you read newspapers so often. I would give chance to one person to explain what a CRR is. Let me see your awareness level. Ah, good. You guessed it or you knew it. What is cash reserve ratio, by the way?
It's the amount which is supposed to be at the bank.
Which bank?
The Reserve Bank.
Where is this cash coming from?
Like the investors, investment from the investors, they get the cash, and the cash,
good. Who's speaking, by the way? I really like it. Who's this?
Gandhar.
Oh, Gandhar is there. Okay, Gandhar. So the thing is, when you put your money in the bank, So what does bank do with that money? They lend it to those people who require it for their business, for farming, whatever XYZ, but they are not supposed to lend everything. So if you give 100 rupees to your bank, the bank is supposed to give those or keep it reserved 4 rupees. Right now it's around 4%, I believe. You have to just check the current rate. So that much is kept reserved for all exigencies. So they are not supposed to give everything out for other purposes. So that's mandated by the agency called, or the institution called, Reserve Bank of India. Okay, that's called cash reserve ratio. It impacts lots of macroeconomic factors like inflation, interest rate, and other things you'll get to know as you learn economics later on this year. Okay, so it is maintained. Next question. Oh, sorry, I could not show the. Never mind, you will see this thing. This is a good question. I don't know if you're observant, really observed it. In how many languages 100 rupees is written on an Indian 100 rupees banknote? And you must also know how many scheduled languages are there in this country. It's mentioned in, most of you know it, lots of people are good, right? Yes, 17. 15 was there on the panel, and 2 English and Hindi. So in total, 17. Okay, got it. 15 was there in the panel. Marathi, Gujarati, Odia, Bengali, Tamil, Kannada, Malayalam, Telugu, all that. Okay, and you must also know about the scheduled languages in this country. It's mentioned in the constitution. Next question. Very close fight it is. Oh my God. One wrong here and there and things will go topsy-turvy. Okay, here is 39th question. Let's say if you know this, if you ever inquired about this, why is stainless steel stainless? What makes it stainless? What do you do so? What do you do for making it stainless? Good that oxygen and argon was not clicked by anyone. But it is chromium. Around 11% of chromium is there in steel, right? So that it fiddles with the reaction process of oxygen and iron, and there is no rusting. Okay, and my dear friends, the last question of the evening, be prepared. Before that, the last leaderboard. And do please give some feedback on the quiz, on general awareness quiz, so that we get some direction after the quiz is over. So let's go for the last question, guys. Last question is this. Before you go to bed or in the morning, you gulp a glass full of milk, you must know about it. Oh my God, why? Why did you spoil it? Okay. Good. So many of you know. That's nice. It's around 4% of fat, 4% of proteins, right? And then lactose and then water. So around when you, next time you are drinking milk, you are drinking water. Okay, so here is the final leaderboard of the evening. And so Gandhar is on first position, followed by Raghav, Anika, Nitin, and who's this? Roshan, and then Tarun and Dhruv, and what? Akshay Sujesh, Ashish Sujesh, and Roshni. Very, very good. Congratulations, Gandhar. Well done. I hope you enjoyed the quiz. Okay, so please, if you enjoyed the quiz, write your specific feedback in Mockstra if possible, so that we could take your feedback and work on it. Right, I hope this was good quiz for all of you. Did you guys enjoy the quiz? Was it useful for you? Did you learn something today? Did you learn something today? Did you know every question or
sir,
you know?
It's the circular? Most fun time I've had, sir.
Sorry, Ahan, could not get you. Come again. Could not get you, Ahan.
So it's really fun.
Okay, good. Thanks for that feedback. So we will try to you know organize more such thing. So learning for you is be more aware. So don't believe on things which you know. Don't even believe on what you see. Also go beyond that. Try to figure out what is the reason behind whatever you are observing. Okay, so that's how you build. It's not a overnight process. It will take a lot of time to be generally aware. Okay, and if possible, read one newspaper on a daily basis. You will get to know so many other facts as well. Okay, chalo bhai log, thanks a lot. Enjoy. We'll see you from tomorrow onwards in your regular classes. And if possible, drop in few lines in Voxtrap about the quiz. Thank you. Good night.
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye. Everything is available on YouTube as well. So the full playlist of all centimars are there. It is being updated, so you can always go back to previous centimars. Thanks again, guys. Thanks for your time. Good night and see you again. Bye.